Today we've got a light tempo workout, and then we'll talk about the plan for the New York City Runs Brooklyn Half Marathon. So that turned into a really nice, bright, sunny day, warmer than I actually expected. And these tempo workouts are always hard to kind of share the exact paces and everything, but basically I'll just put the workout plan on the screen right now. And it was essentially a 40-minute workout, but I did a 10-minute warm-up, did 20 minutes at a tempo pace, which was between about 8:05 and 8:15. This is an effort that's not as fast as my threshold effort, but just kind of a nice steady tempo effort, getting the heart rate up, getting my stride working a little bit before we go into the New York City Runs Brooklyn Half Marathon this weekend. So those middle 20 minutes were that workout tempo pace. And then what I did in the last 10 minutes, and this will connect to what I'm about to talk about with the plans for the Brooklyn Half, is I spent the last 10 minutes kind of dropping back to a cool down, but also still keeping the pace around like 9 minutes per mile to 9:10 per mile. I think it actually came out a little bit faster than that in the end, but that was my goal, was just to hold like that 9 minute to 9:10 pace. And basically, that's what I'm going to be doing during the New York City Runs Brooklyn Half Marathon this weekend. Many of you know, if you've been following along, this is not a peak race for me. I'm excited to share the expo, which I'm going to be going to tomorrow. Excited to share all the race amenities, the race experience. This is the first time that I'm running in New York City, really with anybody other than New York Roadrunners. And I love that there's now becoming this variety or this competition for New York Roadrunners, because that's good for us runners. We don't only want one option. And the fact that New York City Runs has made their way all the way up to this point where they are now a large scale half marathon in the five boroughs, you know, they don't quite have probably the funding to run something as big as like the New York City Marathon or as big as the New York City Half Marathon, but they're getting close. This is gonna be a big field, this is gonna be a big race, and I'm glad that there's somebody else out there doing it. They have an Adidas sponsorship now for the race, that's huge. So they're making big moves, and I'm excited to be a part of it, even if it just happens to work out that it's not gonna be a peak race for me. I'm gonna get a good, long, hard effort out there at about 9 to 9:15 per mile. Should come in right around a 2-hour half marathon time, but again, it's really just gonna be a long, kind of harder effort as far as my training block, and then we're really focusing on the New York Roadrunners Brooklyn Half Marathon down the road in May. That's going to be, you know, the peak race where I really go all out race pace, pick my best shoes, my best taper, everything like that. So that's what we're working towards. But the plan for this race just going to be focusing on good, steady, long effort, you know, 13.1 miles, of course, and just have fun and take in everything that they can offer on the course this weekend. One thing that I will mention, just because I can't, you know, make good on what I hoped to kind of bring to all of you, I wanted to do a preview of the race course, but it just turns out that I've had a lot of different races, and I think the 11-mile run this past weekend would have been the opportunity for me to kind of run parts of the course and share a little bit of what to expect. But unfortunately, you know, just happened to fall on Easter weekend, and I didn't really see that, you know, way back when I planned out the training block. So of course I wasn't going to be in Manhattan or in Brooklyn at the time to film that portion of the course. But what I will say is this, where the race starts and all the way kind of around Kent Avenue and through the part of Brooklyn called Dumbo, if you're coming from out of town, all of that is kind of a waterfront area, and there are really very little hills. It's pretty flat in that section of Brooklyn. Where you're going to start to see the hills are as you come up the portion right under the Manhattan Bridge, and the course kind of loops up and does a reverse of the New York City half marathon that I ran just a few weeks ago. And so I can kind of show you clips of me running this in the opposite direction. So it was a big downhill section in the early stages of the New York City half marathon before you go over the bridge. And basically, this is the part you're going to look out for, because now you're going to be going up that hill towards Prospect Park. So I'll show you the portion of the map here. This is really the point to focus on if you're racing all out. Make sure that you have enough energy in the bank to actually make it up this, you know, about mile and a half section up towards Prospect Park. Once you get into Prospect Park can be a little bit hilly, but just seeing kind of where you enter the park and where you finish within the park, it's going to be a more downhill heavy section of the course in Prospect Park itself. There'll be some rolling hills and things, but I think overall your distance covered in Prospect Park will be net downhill. So your big uphill is going to be that long stretch after the Manhattan Bridge, and then your downhill section at the end is going to be in Prospect Park. So just keep that in mind. I'm sorry again that I couldn't bring some actual visuals, but again, you can kind of see, just imagine it in reverse, me running downhill from the New York City half marathon. We're going to now be coming in the reverse direction for this Brooklyn half marathon. So just to give you a sense, you know, that's really the only thing I can think to look out for. Again, a lot of the early mileage, I've run those streets and things before in the past, and it's just pretty flat, pretty much waterfront area, so there's not a lot of hills to be seen in that section. So that's everything I can really think of. Again, it's not a full-on race plan for the Brooklyn half coming up, just because it's really a long workout for me. But I hope that that kind of answers just a little bit of the questions you may have, and at least preps you for what I'm going to be able to share based on, you know, what my plans are for the race. So thanks for watching, everybody. I hope we get some good weather. I haven't even looked at the forecast. Remind me down below who is going to be racing this New York City Runs Brooklyn Half Marathon as well. And hopefully I'll see some of you around. Obviously, I have a lot more flexibility since I'm really just doing this for fun. So if you run into me, feel free to say hello. Don't feel like you're taking me out of my element or anything like that. I'm just out there to have fun and hopefully share this race with all of you who can't make it. And with that said, I hope to see you all in the next video.